Okay, so in the last lecture, we started unit number 2, if you remember. Now, I request everyone just revise which topics we discussed in last lecture. I already told you in last lecture we started unit number 2, that is static and dynamic force analysis. Which topics, which points we discussed in last? Yes. Yes. D'Alembert principle. Actually, I told you to go through that principle, if you remember. What D'Alembert principle is exactly, I told you in brief, but I told you to search about that, read about that. Along with that, any other points we discuss? Yes. Inertia, good. Any other points? No. Everyone, please tell me one point. Yes, please. Sorry. Yes, loudly, yeah, please, because, yes. Very good. Yes, next. Those are online, you can. Reply your answer in chat box, or you can tell me it.
Mass moment of inertia.
Okay, mass moment of inertia. Yes, you please. Okay, next. Polar moment of inertia. Okay, actually I have not discussed this topic, but okay, you remember that? Good. Yes. Area moment of inertia. Yes. Next. Mass moment of inertia. Next, please. Others, I am asking these people who are present here. And I am just repeating what they are saying. So, you get an idea what they are saying? Yes, please. Okay, it's discussed already. Next. Yes. Okay, next. Moment of inertia. Next. See, so if you remember, the last lecture we started about basic concepts already which are known to you and which are important for starting this fundamental. That is, to discuss static and dynamic force analysis. If you remember what I discussed, I started with concept of, yes, what is inertia that we discussed, then concept of when to use mass moment of inertia, when to use area moment of inertia, in strength of material, use all numericals to find out moment of inertia. But I hope you know that you find out area moment of inertia. Yes or no? Yes. In strength of material, so on. But now we have to discuss about mass moment of inertia. As we are dealing with force analysis, and force analysis, it means we have to find out kinematic analysis, we have to go for kinetic analysis. In that case, we need to discuss with, we need to study mass moment of inertia. Okay. So I told you what inertia is, the mass moment of inertia, area moment of inertia. After that is, next please, which topic we discuss next? Only this?
Whole sky, whole sky. Sky.
Yes, please. Repeat, repeat. Yes. Any other topic we discuss about? I told you rigid body, if you remember. We started with rigid body, inertia, mass moment of inertia, area moment of inertia. Along with this, any other topic?
Yes, sir.
Yes. 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 SHM. So we discuss about SHM. In SHM, we discuss about time period.
Assembly. Inertia. What time do you have to work?
I'm ready to. Others, if you have to give answer, then only mute your
microwave. It is ready as a sunrise.
Others, please mute yourself.
Groove your radius ka sun.
Frequency.
Bottom view water lala.
Everyone, please mute yourself. If you want to give answer, then only you can unmute. Okay, so we just discuss basic topics. I hope you will revise that. And after that, I talk about D'Alembert principle. And all we know, this principle is used to solve which problems? Correlative problem. Inertia. Okay, remember this is used to solve in dynamics. When you are going to solve dynamics problem, It is used for dynamic equilibrium. So, in order to solve problems with dynamic equilibrium, related with dynamic equilibrium, we are going to use Dirac principle. It is nothing but what? I told you in the last also. Resultant force, what happens? Suppose there is one body here, and if I apply some force like this, I'm not saying this is one force. Let's say this is resultant force here. Due to this force, there will be displacement of the body.
It grew right in here.
Hello, someone please tell him to mute himself. Who is that? I can't identify.
So Sanket Deshmukh kon ahe na tancho mic mute
don.
Okay, I will check.
Video ne 3 incomplete hai. Dimension
Sanket Deshmukh. Sanket Deshmukh.
Welcome diagram.
Okay. So, Dirac principle basically used for solving equilibrium problem. I told you, let's say consider one body. On this body, F is acting. Now, what is F? It's not a single force. I'm saying it is resultant force. Now, it may be a combination. Mechanics you may see, it is combination of number of forces. And I find out resultant force. Now, due to resultant force, there will be some motion of the body. In which direction? Where this body will move? In which direction this body will move? In direction of resultant force. Okay, so let's say there is motion of the body, and in order to maintain this body in dynamic equilibrium, if I want to consider this body in dynamic equilibrium, then some opposite force must be applied in opposite direction of this force, and that force is nothing but an inertia force. It is imaginary force which is applied to maintain this body in dynamic equilibrium. Okay. And if these two forces are there, the result of this force is nothing but what? This body will be in equilibrium. So what I can write now, resultant force, let's say it is Fr plus, Fr must be equal to this. So this body in equilibrium. Understand? That's what basics of Dirac forces. Of course, you have to use that. And now, to solve dynamic equilibrium problems, we need to apply inertia force. So what is inertia force? What is inertia force? Yes, please. Let's say I am writing here Fr is equal. I told you how to find out how inertia force plays its role in dynamic equilibrium. Now I have to find out its magnitude. How to find inertia force magnitude? Fr is equal to mass into acceleration. Simple. Force is equal to mass into acceleration is equal to mass into acceleration. If it is, now it is where the force is applied in linear direction. Then there is acceleration. But instead of force, if I apply torque, then suppose this is CG of the body. When this force passes to CG, there will be a moment. Instead of that, if I apply force here, it is, let's say, F I 1. What happened to this force? Rotational motion. Yes or no? There will be some torque. At what distance the torque is acting? Let's say it is R or some distance. So this force already has, will apply some torque on this body and it will produce a rotational motion. Okay. Now what I am saying, instead of that, if it is torque is there, what I can write here? Instead of inertia force, okay, you can see somewhere other. Okay. If it is inertia force, what I am calling it as? Inertia torque. Okay. So what it is nothing but TI. Inertia torque is equal to what? Instead of mass, it will be mass moment of inertia. Now this is coming to our picture. I told you, inertia is of area and mass moment. Which inertia we are dealing with now? Mass moment of inertia, as we are considering mass here. Okay. So it's I into A. Instead of A, you write it is linear acceleration. Here it will be angular acceleration. So it is I into alpha. So actually, all basics. So torque is equal to, inertia torque is equal to I into alpha. What I am trying to tell you, in order to solve dynamic equilibrium problems, what we require? We require inertia force. Are you getting or not? To get inertia force, what I need? Mass moment of inertia. Just go in the sequence. What I required first? Mass moment. I required inertia force. To find inertia force, what will you need? Inertia torque, inertia force, what will you need? Mass moment of inertia. Now, how to find mass moment of inertia? You solve area momentum inertia numericals in form. Now I'm dealing with, I'm trying to tell you how to determine mass momentum inertia. Are you getting or not? It's very simple. What we discussed up to now, I will solve these problems. Total I will apply D'Alembert principle. To apply D'Alembert principle, what I will find out? This force is known to you. Result of force is known to you. What I will find out? Inertia force. Or can say inertia? Instead of this, I can call inertia torque. It is angular motion. So I have to find out inertia force. I have to find out inertia torque. To find out this inertia torque, what need to find out? How I can find out this? I told you. Torque is equal to. Alpha is known to angular acceleration, so I have to find out how mass moment of inertia. So the question is how to find out mass moment of inertia. Anyone? Are you getting what we are discussing now? All of you. Our topic is now how to find out, how to determine mass moment of inertia. Online people, you are getting on.
Summation of radius of gyration.
Yes, that's right. Means, yes, you are right. To find out mass moment of inertia, we know that I is equal to, you know this formula. Is it right or not? Have you heard about this formula? I is equal to m into k square somewhere? Yes. Right or wrong? Or right? Tell me at least. Is it right formula or wrong formula? Is it right or not? Yes, it is right. M into k square. Means, to find out mass moment of inertia, I must know what is mass of the object, what is mass of the body. At the same time, along with mass, I must know what is radius of gyration. Who is, means I have to get mass moment of inertia. To solve this problem, I must know what is, yes, what is radius of gyration. Now, that is our topic, next topic. How to find out radius of gyration. And why to find out radius of gyration? I told you reason. I hope you understand. Why to find out radius of gyration? To solve dynamic problems. Are you sure? No. To solve problems based on D'Alembert principle. Because if we know mass momentum, if we know radius of gyration, you can determine. What you can determine? Last change. If you know k, what you can find out? I you can find out. Okay. If you know I, then what you can find out? Torque, or you can say? Inertia force. Okay, it depends which kind of motion is there, which kind of force is applied, and hence we can solve problems. So now we have discussed how to find out radius of gyration. If you remember, can anyone tell me if the bodies, objects, whose radius of gyration we need to find out are simple, having simple geometrical shapes? Can we determine k by using some formulas? Or is there any standard formula available to determine k? Yes, all of you. Is any formula available to determine radius of gyration k for simple geometrical shapes? Let's say I talk about a circular ring, you can see. Or let's say circular disc, you can see. Not ring, I'm saying. A disc is there. Solid disc, circular disc. Can I find out k of this? Or instead of solid, I can say thin disc is there. Okay. Let's say consider one rod of length L. One rod
right is there. Camera through one. Right side.
Is not visible?
Not visible.
Hope it is visible because it is visible to me on screen.
It is visible.
Yes. See what I consider two cases. One is circular disc, a thin circular disc, and second one is yes. A rod of length L. How to find out k of these objects? I hope it is known to you. Yes, anyone please, physical, yes. Loudly please.
I can discuss on dx, we consider some.
Where means how to find, what is k formula of this? What is k formula of this? Yes, anyone? So, what I conclude here, you must know what are the formulas for simple geometrical shapes which are available. Actually, it is not part of our syllabus. Remember, this must be known to you. Let's say here, for a rod of length L, its k is equal to L only. K is equal to L only. If it is thin circular disc, k is equal to. I know it is discussed many times in physics. K is equal to R by root. Have you heard about this or not? कुठे तर ऐकलं असणार दोन हजार डिप्लोमा पेपर 2000 रेग्युलर स्टुडंट टू मस्ट दिस सो मीन्स व्हॉट आय कन्क्लुडिंग हियर फॉर अ सिंपल जॉमेट्रिकल शेप्स सम फॉर्म्युलाज आर अवेलेबल टू डिटरमाइन k बट if I want to find out k of a connecting rod now why connecting rod we are mechanical engineers and our topic is what static and dynamic force analysis what is our subject name yes what is our subject name yes all of you ask see I am not asking only for these people so sorry for talking I am asking you also what is our subject name yes अरे कॉम मीन्स व्हाट
कॉम काइनेमेटिक ऑफ मोशन
काइनेमेटिक्स ऑफ मोशन
काइनेमेटिक्स ऑफ मोशन लेट्स टेक सिंपल एग्जांपल ऑफ आईसी इंजन मशीनरी वी डोंट गो फॉर कंप्लीट मशीन आईसी इंजन इन आईसी इंजन देयर आर डिफरेंट अच्छा डिफरेंट पार्ट्स आर देयर डिफरेंट लिंक्स आर देयर डिफरेंट गियर्स आर देयर एंड आई विल से इन दैट अ सिंपल मैकेनिज्म इज देयर करते हैं बड़े स्लाइडर क्रैंक मैकेनिज्म सो व्हाट अबाउट स्लाइडर क्रैंक मैकेनिज्म अरे सो ओके अरे स्लाइडर क्रैंक मैकेनिज्म any mechanism there is connecting rod what in anybody inside a tank but there is connecting rod now I told you determine k or your find out for a dynamic analysis of the solid tank mechanism anyhow you need to find out k of that rod k of that object that is k of what connecting rod how we can determine it is not a simple shape now because if you draw connecting rod properly will you say this is connect k formula for this no so for complex shapes for complicated bodies to find out k is formula are not sufficient and hence to find out k of such a kind of body I am not saying it is not only connecting rod any configured shape body any configured shape object I can find k by using some experimental methods now which are the methods that we are to discuss now so our next topic actually this is our main topic first topic in unit number 2 is you can write on this experimental methods to determine radius of gyration This is our actual syllabus package for unit number 2. All before this is only prerequisites, basics. Okay. Now can you tell me which are the experimental methods available? Experimental methods to find k. Now why to find out k? I told you. Why to find out k? It is known to you. Now we have to find out k. Why it is known to you? Okay. Now the question is how to find out. Why to find out? I told you. Now we have to discuss how to find out k by using some methods. The methods are. It's very simple. I am saying a compound pendulum method. And all these topics there are practicals, and we have setups in our lab. Compound pendulum method. Second one is bipolar suspension method. Young stands for method, okay. And third one is triangular. So these are the three methods used to determine radius of gyration of a complicated shapes, or I'm saying complex bodies. I just highlighted here: compound, bipolar, and triangular. Those are online. Also, you can note down this. Completed. Just add on this. We'll discuss in one by one detail. Don't worry. Okay. I hope completed. Yes. Compound pendulum method, then bipolar suspension method, and tripolar suspension method. These are the three methods that we are going to study, which are used to determine k experimental. Okay, I hope topic is clear. What we are going to discuss? Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
It should not be like that. You are coming here attending lectures and you don't know what we are discussing now. Otherwise, don't come. Don't attend. That is my suggestion to all. Okay, so before now, this was first method we discuss.
Compound
pendulum method. Before compound pendulum, I hope all of you heard about yes famous yes. I hope all of you heard about this, all of you studied this in 12th science. 11th or 12th science. Simple pendulum. I saw no.
Yes.
Okay. Now tell me how to find out radius of gyration of simple pendulum. Already known to you. Compound pendulum, we will discuss that. Let's say talk about simple pendulum. Yes. Now, what simple pendulum is? Let's say I consider one point of suspension. Try to concentrate here. Request over. This is point of suspension. About this point of suspension, let's say we take one string or let's say take one thread like this, having length here. At the end of this thread or let's say string or wire, we attach one ball of mass m. I hope I told you some terminology to you. First, I told you this is point of suspension O. O is point of suspension. How much length of the string I told you? Yes, how much it is? L. Let's say small arrow, capital arrow, you can take anything. And M is mass of this ball which is suspended at the end of the string. I already told you, if I give some torque to this pendulum, whatever, or not given torque, under the action of gravity only, what happened? Have you seen some of the clocks? Python clocks with this simple pendulums. Okay. Now how they are oscillating? Is there an external torque we are providing them? Providing to this? Is there an external torque we are providing to make it oscillate? A yes or no? Yes. No. They will oscillate under the action of gravity. Let's say I will consider this weight here. So the weight mass m, mass is m. Yes, weight will be. Yes, weight will be mg.
Yeah, mg.
So that weight is acting out. If I just resolve this weight, two components. These two components are resolving. You can observe here. These are the two components of this weight. One in direction of the string, other perpendicular to the string. Okay. Apparently. Due to which torque this pendulum will oscillate? Let's say this small displacement is there. Theta is angular displacement given or angular displacement of this pendulum with reference to mean position. Why I said mean position? Because this, I assume that this ball will oscillate. Is it visible at all? This blue color is visible for you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
If not, we'll change it. What I am saying, it will, this is part of this pendulum and this pendulum will oscillate above this position. Let's say this one is mean position, let's say this point is B and the two extreme positions I will take, I will not assume this is the extreme position. It's maybe the extreme position is C here, another extreme position is, it must be same one, approximately at least. Same on both sides. Okay. It will be A and this will be C. What is A and C? So I think it is you are not comfortable in this position. If not, then you change your position. If you are not comfortable, you can also change your position. Okay, so what is A and C? This? Extreme position of this pendulum. What is
extreme
B?
Position of pendulum?
B is mean position. About it, mean. Oscillate. Now, my question to you is, which torque is responsible here to produce this oscillation? How much magnitude of that torque is? How much torque magnitude which makes this pendulum to oscillate? What is magnitude of that torque? Yes.
Mg sin theta.
See, Mg sin theta, is it a torque? You are not wrong, I am saying partial is correct.
Into any cost theta. Any cost theta is that our idea is that
okay. You should, you must think about this. Now what I am considering. So what I consider, a string of length L and then of string, I am considering one ball of mass M and this will oscillate under the action of gravity. Okay. Now, I can say the torque acting. Let's say first find out inertia force here. Inertia torque. So how to find inertia torque is torque. I told you already. Inertia torque is equal to just we discuss theory before this. That's why I take that background because you will be aware about this. How to find inertia torque? I into alpha. Are you sure? I into alpha. What is I? Mass moment of inertia into alpha. Alpha is angular acceleration. This is acceleration with which this body is accelerating. That's angular acceleration. Okay, or accelerating. Okay. Now how to find this I? You know formula. You know formula. What is formula? I is equal to m into c square. Are you sure? This is simple object, string only. We can find out of this. That is nothing but L. What I told you before. So for simple geometric concepts, k is available, k is known. Okay. So I is equal to m into k square into alpha. But what is k? Since k is equal to l here, are you sure? Why l? String of length l. Okay. So what I can write here? M l square into alpha. It is your I. Sorry. Inner circle. Yes or no? Now this body, when I say it, this body is in equilibrium, and these two forces maintain this body in equilibrium. These two torques are same. So force under it will be torque. One is inertia torque, all time under. Any other torque is there? That is basics of D'Alembert principle. Application of D'Alembert principle. If you are confused about D'Alembert, this is the application. I already told you the diagram equilibrium. I told you one thing. What I told you, there is one force, resultant force, and then the opposite force, what is it? Inertia force. Under the action of these two forces, this body is in equilibrium. Now apply it here, tell me. One thing I told you, what is this? Inertia torque. Which one is dependent now? Inertia torque must be applied in opposite direction of resultant torque. So who is resultant torque here? How much resultant torque is? That is nothing but gravity force. The torque produced due to gravitational force. How much gravitational force is mg? Okay, now which torque is responsible for? There are two components of this mg. One is, yes, not mg. This one is cos, addition. This one is sin. I hope you are all aware about this. Cos, sin, okay. This one is mg, cos, theta. Is it right? Yes or no? This one is, mg, sin, theta. Out of this, which force will produce torque? Now, don't consider resultant force. Because I already split this force into two components. Are you sure no? Otherwise, you take three forces. Then there is only two split. Directly take M. Can I find out torque due to this force M directly? Yes, I can find out. At that time, what I do then? I can order one. Mechanics question, not wrong question. Wrong question. What I said, instead of replacing this force by two components, can I find out resultant torque directly with MG? Yes? That's what we did already. Okay, I resolve this force into two components. It is simple, you know, method. Okay, resolution and composition. We discuss in engineering mechanics. I hope so. Okay, out of this now, forget about resultant force. I resolve two components. Which force is responsible for torque? If I consider this mg cos theta, online, responsibility. Okay. If I consider this force component mg cos theta, is this component producing torque? Yes or no? Yes or no? Is this mg cos theta will produce torque? Yes or no?
No.
How we never no. Sure it will, sorry, it may produce some torque. Anyone saying like this? Or there is confusion? How we never saying, sir, I am confused. Yes, please. Anyone? Just raise your hands and be relaxed. It is not like it is mandatory to give yes or no. If you are not knowing, tell me. If you are saying, sir, we don't know this, I will discuss it. Otherwise, I will assume that it won't be. I'll go ahead. So it is your loss, not my loss. So I request you, when you are confused, you ask me. My question to you is, to all basically, those are physical, those are online, mg cos theta, is there any chance it will produce any torque above this point of suspension? Of course, I'm considering this, I am finding about point of suspension. Yes or no? Yes or no? No? Anyone saying yes? Yes from online? Anyone saying yes? If you are really happy, then you come. Okay. Now tell me, whether this MJ cost is going to stop? No. Why not? Because it's passing through center. See, I am finding moment of inertia. I am finding all thing about point of suspension. And this force is passing through the point of suspension. If any force passing through the suspension, torque will be zero. Because zero basically torque is force into perpendicular distance. No perpendicular distance. Zero perpendicular distance means zero torque. Okay. But it's not useful component for me. Which one is useful to me? MG sin theta. Of course, it will be useful because it is having some perpendicular distance about the point of suspension. MG sin theta into how much the distance is? How much the distance is? L. It is nothing but your torque force into perpendicular distance. So my torque, I am saying actual torque, resultant torque, you are confused. Are you getting wrong? There are the principle I have applied. I find out inertia torque, I am finding now. Yes, last base, what I am finding now? Resultant torque. And how much is this telling you? Please. Are you please tell me? Yes. I am not audible, please tell me. Tell me now. Yes? I ask you how much this torque is. Can you tell me now? Yes. Last. Yes, you. Very good. L into MG. Is it clear torque? Others, it's very simple. Okay. So, force into MG sin theta. MG sin theta into distance. MG sin theta. That is your force into. Into this distance, how much it is? L. So, MG sin theta into L. Equation number? Okay, I have not called equation number 2. Now only. So, this is my inertial torque, this is my resultant torque. But we know, if you know about oscillation and simple pendulum, this will produce simple harmonic motion. I am saying the pendulum motion is essential only when this angle theta is small. This is one assumption. When I discuss this in a SHM. Now, after I discuss with you what SHM is, you know the equations. You remember the equations of SHM? Frequency, time period, only two are sufficient. Okay, what I am saying here, it will produce SHM only when this theta is small. Now, my question to you is, this, how much theta must be? To call this motion as SHM, what is range of theta? Are you getting? Then I say small displacement, small angular displacement, how much that angular displacement is? Theta range, 100 degree, 30 degree, 1000 degree, something. Are you getting or not? So you have to answer me this in next lecture. You need to search about this, everything is available. Just the requirement is, you must have that courage, you must have that answering willpower to search that. If you search it, you will get answer. Okay. So in next lecture, I will ask this, how much that range is, but okay. When, you can note this one, you have to give this answer. Next, when this theta is small, I will say this one is, which kind of motion it is? SHM. Okay, when theta is small, for SHM, I can say this MG sin theta, as theta is small, I can write here, yes, when I can write sin theta is approximately equal to theta. Can I write like this? Are you sure? No. When theta is small, I can write sin theta is equal to theta. Yes, I can write this. So my equation is now, yes, TI is equal to, is it visible online?
Is it visible? Yes.
This portion I'm saying. Equation number 2. This is your resultant torque equation. Okay. Now, to solve, to apply D'Alembert principle, that is for dynamic equilibrium. What I can write for dynamic equilibrium is, to say this body, this compound simple pendulum is dynamic equilibrium, what is our condition? What is our condition for dynamic equilibrium? D'Alembert principle, resultant torque and inertia torque must be equal to each other. Must be equal to each other. Or, that is, I can say Pi plus Pr must be equal to 0. What is the meaning of this? These two are equal in magnitude, opposite in direction. Okay. Now put it here. Or you can integrate it. So it is what m into L square into alpha is equal to, yes, mg theta into L. So why I find out this? I have to find out radius of variation. add panel radius of burst. Same time we can determine, you can determine time period as well as frequency of a simple pendulum. My question to you is how to determine time period of simple pendulum, or what is basic equation for time period in SHM? I told you this is SHM, this motion is SHM. So you consider this motion as SHM and then find out time period equation from this. Yes, anyone? How to find time period? How to find time period? Basically, tell me equation only. Forget about other things. Yes. Okay. If you remember last lecture, now okay, I'll continue from this. If you remember last lecture, I discussed some concept. When I discuss SHM, okay, I'm writing here concept of SHM in brief. Pretty visible. This all of it. Okay. What we discuss SHM in the human acceleration is equal to S omega square into X. A is equal to omega square into X. What I get from this? What is omega? Root of A by X. What is A? What is A? Acceleration. What is X? Displacement. Means if the motion is SHM, then omega is equal to A by X. Are you sure? Next, now what is time period? Now?
2 pi upon.
Time period 2 pi upon omega. How to remember this? Don't bother this apart from one case. If you see this, there is nothing to remember this. Just we need to recall basic concepts. How to remember time period formula? Very simple. Theta is equal to. Yes, theta is equal to omega into t. Yes or no? Go to the right side, basic relation. Theta is equal to omega, omega to time period. How much theta in that SHM? Or SHM is circular, I am saying that. Periodic motion, repeated every time. So theta is nothing but SHM, theta, 2 pi, 360 degree, simple. I mean, that in I am writing it as 2 pi. 2 pi omega into time period. So what is time period formula? 2 pi upon omega. What is frequency then? 1 upon time period formula. Frequency is nothing but 1 upon time period. Is it clear or how I connect this? Actually, this is not my task. Huh? This is not my task. Form, you are in second year. Huh? It must be clear at 12th level or diploma level. If it's something. Okay. Okay. Time period is what? I tell you formula. 2 pi upon omega. Frequency. Frequency 1 upon time period. Use this here. Now see what I am finding. Actually, I am finding no alpha by theta from this. Up to here it is clear. What I did only, I applied here number principle. Then I am from this equation, I am finding alpha by theta. What is alpha by theta? Young get cancer. Yes. Solve this. This is L also. Could be G. Yes. Alpha by theta is equal to G by. Not only. What is omega? Formula omega only. See here. A by X, no? What is A? Acceleration. What is X? Displacement. Displacement. Can I write this? What is alpha? Acceleration. What is theta? What is theta? Displacement. So what I can write? Omega is equal to root of alpha by theta. Is it right? Are you sure? No? Yes. It is equal to alpha by theta. Root of S? G by L. Here I can write the sine theta is equal to theta. So if this omega is root of G by L, what is time period formula? Time period 2 pi upon omega or omega upon 2 pi. Time period is equal to 2 pi upon omega. Okay. So it is 2 pi upon omega. What is omega? Root of G by L. What I can write here is L by G. What is frequency then? Why I said FN? FN stands for natural frequency. Okay. Yes, next. FN is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root of G by. So these are the equations for a simple pendulum. time period equation, frequency equation for a simple filter. Actually, remember the basic derivation to find out time period and frequency based on why. Actually, I have discussed compound pendulum now. Before next step is compound pendulum. However, might be a question in front of you, sir. When you started this topic, you said we need to find out K. If you remember what I said, we have to find out K, radius of direction. We have different methods. One method is compound pendulum, other one is bipedal, tripedal. And for understanding compound pendulum, we are finding simple pendulum. Where is K? How to find K? How to find K in this case? Actually, K is known here. K is known here. K is known here. For simple pendulum, there is no need to find K by using experimental method. It's directly known to K is equal to L. But still, this will help you to solve problems on compound pendulum. So, for getting easier, for getting to understand compound pendulum in easier way, we discuss here simple method. Now, you have to apply same methodology. Why I discuss this in detail? Because next three derivations, compound pendulum, bipedal, tripedal are same. Next three derivations, next three methods are same. What you have to remember? First step, consider it, diagram basically. I am telling you summary of the lecture. Second, I have to solve it DRMR principle. I have to solve dynamic problem. So what? Two things required for me. One is, I might apply DRMR, what will be required? Inertia torque, other one is resultant torque. Or you can say, you know, resultant force and inertia force. So two things I have to find out. That only I did. In the first step, I find out inertia torque. So get your inertia torque first. Second thing, get your resultant torque. What is next step? You tell me, yes. What is next step? Equate them. Yes or no? Here I equate them. Equate them. Get value of omega. How to find omega? Known to you. Use knowledge of SHM. Get omega, get time period, get frequency. Clear or not? Is it clear? In next lecture, you have to help me to solve a derivation on compound pendulum. I think it is clear. Okay, any doubt? Okay. Yes, online, any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. I will share attendance link if required. If attendance is not proper, then I will share Google form. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.